morning light. It's time to talk to the Lord today. Let's all bow our heads and close our eyes and talk to the Lord. Dear Jesus, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you for giving us traveling mercies to come here safely. Lord, we had plans, but that's okay because we will still praise you no matter what. And Lord, we pray that whatever's going on today, we know that you still love us.
Yes.
Sickness, death.
Yes.
We pray for Mr. Grissom.
Yes.
Hope that his transplant goes successful.
Yes.
And Lord, we pray that we will remember you no matter what we face.
Yes.
We know that you will wrap your arms around us, Lord. We can't make this without you. Please give us the strength to do your word. Give us the strength to reach out to others, because we need you more than ever before.
Yes, yes.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
I want to thank PJ for. I just want to make the quick announcement, and I did not say this in the initial announcements. Since our day had changed, we had a lot of things that took place in our AYM. They had to change things. Brother Grissom was going to speak for you then. I want to thank you, the Lord, for the random thinking. Amen.
Amen.
Elder Grissom received a phone call this week that his kidney was red.
Thank you.
Thank you. Let the church say amen, huh? And Jesus is worthy to be praised today, huh? Oh, I don't know about you, he's worthy. He is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be praised. We praise and serve an awesome God. We serve a healing God. We serve a God that shows up and shows out. He is worthy. He is worthy.
More rejoicing in heaven
over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people. Let me say it again, 99 righteous people who do not need repentance. Oh, I want to talk to you today on the subject entitled, Jesus is looking for you. Jesus is looking for you. Holy Ghost, continue to consume our hearts today. Consume our minds today. Take full control, Holy Ghost. Come down like fire. Mess us up today. And remind us that it's only Jesus that keeps us. It is Jesus that saves. Oh, we thank you. High preacher, let Jesus be known. Amen and amen. You may be seated. Jesus is looking for you. Have you ever lost something you care about very much? Let's put it this way. Have you ever lost your keys? You ain't gonna sit down. Let's put it this way to some of our young people. Have you ever lost your cell phone? Boy, y'all go crazy if you lose your cell phone. This is the way Jesus cares about people. He sees you and me as a loss until we come to know his love. No matter where you go and what you do, Jesus is looking for you. You may spend a long time trying to get away from him, but he keeps looking for you everywhere you go. Like the lost sheep and the lost coin and the lost son, you are very special to him. He looks for you. And on the streets where you're walking right now, he's looking for you. And in the classroom, students, he's looking for you. Wherever you at right now, even when you're in your bed at night or in your bed of affliction, Jesus is looking for you. He reminds you that you belong to him. He made you for himself. But you may be wondering for a while from him. You can answer him by saying yes to him and say this to Jesus: Jesus, rescue me. See, if Jesus didn't come looking for you and me, we would be lost. But God's going to show you something today in the story of the lost sheep. The lost coin, the prodigal son, and the lost elder represent every stage of the church today. Oh, I know I'm getting no amens in here today. But we gonna see that we got sheep out there lost in every category. And the thing is this right here. The reason we don't have no power, the reason the churches are not full, is we have forgotten to go look for the lost. Amen. Huh? We have forgotten to go look for the lost. Heaven says this right here. If we look for the lost, there are angels and power ready to give to you. Oh, let's move forward. Y'all want to move forward, huh? Y'all a good group out there. Y'all gonna make me sit down real early, huh? In Luke chapter 15, verse 1, we see that, wherever Jesus went, Jesus had a crowd. But everybody in the crowd ain't always coming to hear what Jesus has to say. That sounds like some of us up in here today, huh? In this crowd, there were sitting some Pharisees and some Republicans. And Jesus heard them murmuring. You don't think Jesus hear you when you're talking about him or talking about anybody else? And they was talking about Jesus. And they listened to what they said to Jesus, about Jesus. They said, who this man think he is? Who do you think he is? What gives him the authority to accept sinners? Not only accept them, but check this out. Then he eats with them. Okay. Now you know who they're talking about, who he ate with, right? Huh? They talking about who? The boy he told the man, he told him to get up out of the sycamore tree, right? Zacchaeus. And so now they are murmuring amongst themselves. Now they are talking against what Jesus do. Let me ask you a question. commercial, let's take a commercial break. Can we go to commercial break? New life. You sitting out there today, what does the publicans and the long man say about you? What that rumor goes about you, huh? I be saying about you, what they say about Jesus, him or her, what they think they doing. They receive sinners. And not only do they receive them, they eat with him. What do people say about you? But they say that Jesus was hanging with sinners. Oh, I thank God for hanging with a sinner. Huh? Oh, you all should jump out of your seat because he ain't nothing but a sinner. Thank God that Jesus take time out for sinners. Let me tell you why these Pharisees felt that way. Let me tell you why they felt that way. See, it was taught by the Jews that before God loves any sinner, he must first repent. Uh-oh, coming down your lane now, huh? Oh, let me say it one more time. Because we do think that, don't we? Probably the only way in Christ is you got to repent. Oh boy, I know it's quiet in this place today. It was taught by the Jews that before God loved and extended to a sinner, he must first repent. And in very view of repentance, it is a work by which man earned the favor of heaven. This is what it was taught, y'all. That when you repent, you got favor from heaven. Are y'all following me today? And it was this taught that led the Pharisees and the Pharisees to have this anger against Christ. According to their ideas, he should permit nor approach a sinner. But in a parable, Jesus tells them this. Jesus let them know, if a man loses a sheep, he got 100 of them, won't he go looking for that one? See, the Pharisees was angry at Jesus because Jesus was receiving sinners before they repented. They didn't have to repent. Jesus was coming for them. Now remember what the title of the message is. What is it? Jesus what? Looking for you. Huh? Jesus says that he had to go and look for that one. And now what happens? What happens? Jesus goes on to tell the story. What happened was, once he found that one, he puts it on his shoulder. Now, he said Jesus told him, what in the world are you going here? What is our first response when we go and we see someone in sin? We're ready to what? To judge them. We're ready to throw stones at them. Jesus said, no, we don't do that. We pick them up, put them on our shoulder, and we bring them home. And when we bring them home, listen to what Jesus said. Call your neighbors. Call church board meetings. Get that. Call business meeting, huh? And say, our lost one has been lost, but now they're found. We are having a Holy Ghost party. Won't you come to her? That's what Jesus said. He told them that they must do. But see, the Pharisees had it backwards. We are a little backwards, too. We think that we, now y'all know our preacher, we thought we was the only ones, huh? We think that God don't go after people who are lost. Amen. Oh, but Jesus had to straighten them up. Listen to what Jesus says to them. This is what Jesus says here. This is what Jesus says to them. He says this right here. He says, I have no need to come and rescue righteous people.
That's right. That's right. That's the word. Yeah. That's the word. Yeah. Hmm?
Yeah. But those who are lost. Oh,
yes.
If you think you all that, then you don't need no Jesus. Huh? Then you go ahead on because I need Jesus in my life. Huh? I need him in my life. So let me tell you something today. Jesus is looking for you. And when we get done today, we're going to come all down your avenue with everybody else. Y'all don't believe me today, huh? Huh? So these Pharisees, they regarded Christ as showing favor to those who are sinners, but they fail to realize that Christ had come to save the lost. Amen. Many children and adults and young people believe that lie, that they are worthless to other people and no good to Jesus. Have you ever felt that way today? Jesus indicates that he came to save the lost. No matter how far or how off you are, Jesus is coming down your boulevard looking for you. If we admit and need your mess.
Yes.
Yes, he will.
You don't believe me, ask the woman in the well.
Thank you.
Jesus shows up in places we wouldn't think he'll show up.
That's right. That's
showed up in her midst. And he never been as being in a place where he wasn't welcome. But he showed up anyway. And he asked her, give me some water. Jesus could have spoke water and water again. But Jesus in the saving business, huh? He uses her to what? To bless him. Oh, thank God that he uses us to bless him, huh? But then Jesus started up a conversation with her. Met her in her mess. He seek and save those which is lost. She says to him, stop talking. And Jesus tells her this, your husband that you with, he ain't none of yours. Oh, I wish I had some help up in this house. Right there in the middle of a mess, Jesus showed up. And when he got through with her, she ran back to the town. This unworthless woman, huh? The one that they talked about. One of the men ran through. Oh, I wish I had some help. Now she runs back to the same town and says, come get ready. That told me everything about her. And the Bible said, the whole town came to meet this man.
Amen.
Why? Because Jesus shows up in your mess.
Yes.
Because if he didn't look for you, you would be lost.
Yes.
The one thing you must know about sheep. Sheep ain't got the sense. And just like you and me. And I don't want to admit, but I'm telling you
just
the
messenger
first. Come on, come on.
They run off and they beat off.
Yes.
And if Jesus don't show up, they'll die in the woods.
Yes.
They ain't got no common sense right. To come back home. They don't even have common sense to drink the right water. Jesus had to lead them to the right water.
Yes, so.
And so they wander off out there, and they're out there right now today, and they don't know how to get home. And the only way they're going to get home is Jesus got to see them. Jesus got to go look for them. Jesus got to send someone in New Life to look for them. We've got to be a part of what God is saying, that we have power at our fingertips, but we as New Life have forgotten about the law. Oh, Lord, I'm sorry, but you told me I had to tell you, so I'm going to tell you. Now, let's go. Y'all a good group, so I'm going to check this out. Y'all a good group, okay? All right, let's go to our first point, our 4 points for the day, all right? Our first point is this right here, the lost sheep. Who the lost sheep want to represent? This sheep here represents those who just wandered off. Those who said that the grass is greener on the other side. Y'all know what I'm right there? Huh? I know someone out there think the grass is greener on the other side, And they wander off to that grass and fail to realize that grass ain't what it says.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
So the lost sheep represent those who are lost. And if Jesus doesn't come get them, now check this out, they will die for it. And so Jesus goes to get them. I don't know about you, but I was that lost sheep one time. I was that lost sheep one time. If Jesus would have come got me out of the corner of the club called Rocking Chair, then I wouldn't be here today. Yes. You need
And see, when you lost like that, you do anything. Oh, well, you do anything. Mm-hmm. But if God didn't come get you, you'll die.
Yes,
in your midst.
Okay.
So the first one is the wild man sheep. Then the second one is this right here, the lost color. Uh-oh, if it come out your pit boulevard now. Okay. The lost color was lost in the house. Represent that there's something you out here lost.
In the house.
In the
house. Yes, sir.
In the house.
In the house.
All right, brother.
Preach. Preach.
And so Jesus has to clean up the house. Huh? give me all of it. And they start living this righteousness, getting all this money and think they all up there. That's why they're going crazy today.
That's right. That's right.
They shoot themselves. That's right. Our buildings.
Amen. Hmm?
They want God's grace and mercy. And they want to go and live any kind of way they want. But let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. For that son that's out there, that daughter that's out there on Facebook Live or here in this church today, let me tell you something. You will come to your senses.
Yes, sir.
And God does things to make you come to your senses.
Yes, sir.
You know how he came to his senses?
Yes, sir.
He got jealous of the pig. See, sometimes when you're so self-righteous, you forget that you say. And now you go to pray because one of the brothers has come back home.
Wow.
But yet you are here feasting off of the good word of the Lord, feasting off of God, and yet you still complain. And so you are lost in your self-righteousness, lost in that you deserve a pardon. You should have been pardoned anyway. You should have been praying to me. But now you get upset because God falls apart for somebody who has come back to him.
Yes, sir.
We represent the elder son when we complain about the loss. Now look at what Jesus said. He did not chastise his sheep. He did not put them down. He did not say to them, what in the world are you doing out there? Mm. He just put his other arms around. Mm. And he tell the other son,
come on.
I got you too.
Amen. Amen.
You belong to me.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Now let's go in. Mm. And let's go. Yeah. Because your brother was lost. But now he found. Oh, I can give rewards today. I will help the old Academy Award. And only one that will get the Academy Award is those who lost, but now it's found. When we going to get more excited for the lost coming home to Jesus? When are we going to get to a point to where we throw parties and be excited when people give their life to Jesus? And we gotta get out of this thing thinking. Now we're getting ready to get into the operation impact. We're getting ready. All I gotta do is, y'all, because I'm evangelist by heart, okay? We gotta get ready to go out and meet those who need Jesus.
Amen.
But this is about to happen now. Jesus said, I gotta go. But I'm gonna leave you a comfort. And the only Jesus that people are going to see is in you and in me.
Yes, sir.
And so now we gotta go and see the lost. So what Jesus did here is he led a roadmap, pastor, on how to bring back a sheep that wandered off. What did he say? Don't say no word to them. Just put them on the shelf. Then he tells you how to save those who are lost in the church. Huh? He tells you how to do that. You got to sweep the floor. And then you find it. Then he tells you about the son who leaves. You gotta let the circumstances. See, some of y'all got children out there. I got some out there too, amen. I've learned to let the circumstances take care of me. That's why I sleep so good. Because God is gonna take care.
Yes, sir.
He just showed you. It's in his word. But see, you gotta let the circumstances take care of them. And you know what happens is, by you looking for them to come home, you'll see them afar off.
Hallelujah.
And then the elder son, we gotta stop being jealous.
Amen.
Because somebody gave their life to Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah, they deserve, you know how I would say they deserve everything they got?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what about you?
Amen.
Deserve what you get. Truth be told, you didn't get what you deserve.
Amen.
So let's stop this and let's get ready to see the loss. Let's get ready to go with a smile on our face. A word of encouragement in our mouths. And strong arms to lift when they're down. And let the circumstances of life deal with those who grew up in this thing and who know Jesus, what I'm saying. If we get out of the way, God will take care of
us.
God will fix everything.
Yes.
The valley of of a soul. Who can put a value on it? Would you know the worth? Go to this end. Then watch Christ through the anguish of blood and sweat. Great drops of blood look up on the Savior's uplifting of the cross. Hear that despairing cry, my God, my God, why have thou forsaken me? Look up on the wounds on his head. The pierced side, the pierced side, the holes in his feet. And remember that Christ risked it all for you. For our redemption, heaven is heaven. For our redemption is heaven, is a place for us. At the foot of the cross reminds us that the one sinner Christ would have laid down his life, you may be that very one. What's the value of a soul? In this work, all the angels of heaven are ready to cooperate. So that's what he says. To give us the power we need. If we will only seek the lost. Christ will die just for you. If there's only been one.
Yes.
So what's the matter? Christ giving up everything. Giving up everything. Jesus is looking for you. The question today is, are you ready to come home? The question today out there on Facebook Live, are you ready to come home? His arms are waiting for you. You waver, child. All you have to do is do like Peter, just cry out, Lord, save me. And you'll be there. Do you want to come home?
Yes, sir.
And then when you come home, God wants you to go out and seek someone else who is lost. How about if you fit that category, if you're a waiting sheep, and you want to come home today, just come on down. Just come on down. You say, I'm a waiting sheep. Oh, God bless you. You said, well, wait with you. I need Jesus. Y'all just don't know that I believe in my life. God bless you, God. Then you will wait for us. You know if you don't come, you're going to wind up dying in your mess. Is everyone else today? Okay. What about your lost soul? You in church, but you lost. You won't be fat. This is what happens. When you come and you're in the church, all you come now is for a fresh start.
Yes, sir.
Huh? God, the Bible says you clean up all that dust off that corner, huh? Gave you a fresh start. All you lost for today. Do you want a fresh start today?
Yes, sir.
Then come on down. Come on down, Pastor. I want a fresh start. I want a new start with Jesus today. You can get it today. You can get today. If you're lost going today, just come on down. If you're on Facebook Live, text in, say something, call the number, say something. If you are the lost going today, just come on down. You want a fresh start. How many want a fresh start today? Oh, what about the parking son? Huh? I was a parking. I'm not part of the door. But you want to come home? You want to come home? It's your opportunity. Come on home. What about your elder son? What about your elder son? Huh? Think you got together and you all went with bad chips? Huh? What about it? What about it? Oh, don't miss the honeycomb with you too, huh? What about it? Well, Lord, I just want to do God's will out of church. Now, this is your church. If you want power,
to save the lost. Then you need to stand on your feet saying, Jesus, I need power to save the lost. And by you standing today, represents that from this day forth, that's a new life. Praise a new life will begin to seek and save that which is lost. Our programs are going to be to save that which is lost. Did God bless your heart today, huh?
Amen.
Did he bless your heart today? Did he set the record straight for you today? Did he give you hope today? Did he show that if you just praise him enough, he will do things, he will work it out for you? See, God told me this message. God, in front of bed of affliction, I need you to get up and see that.
Go ahead and where this my dear brother is. We're gonna lift our hands right here. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, dear Lord, you are powerful, dear Lord, you are omniscient. You are, dear Lord, the one who knows all things. Father, you sit way up high, yet you come way down low and you tabernacle with man. Now, Lord, we ask and pray that you would be with our dear brother Christopher. Father, that we went asking and praying whatever he needs, dear Lord, that you would bless him, dear Lord. Father in heaven, you know, dear Lord, what you want to do in his life, dear Lord, from the top of his head to the little toes of his feet, dear Lord. You, Father, are walking with him. Now, Lord, we ask and pray that you will meet his need as Jehovah Jireh, dear Lord. Father, we ask and pray that you will provide, dear Lord, in every single way, dear Lord. And we thank you and we praise you in advance for what you want to do. It's my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Sister Jones, do you have something that you would like to say? She was our AYN leader, and she has something that she wanted to bring to us today. Again, keep Sister Jones and her family in prayer. We also want to thank her again for her leadership and her husband's leadership. For those of you, they will be rescheduling the evolution of Adventism. So for those of you who want your children to be involved, they had a beautiful beautiful program that was planned. So I'm sure they can go ahead and modify it. But if those of you who have grandkids, nieces, nephews, you want them to be a part of it, please speak with Sister Jones or speak with her husband, Deacon Jones, or speak to Sister Grissom. Right now she's got a lot going on, that's good things. But we want to go ahead and please connect with them, and they would enjoy having their children be a part of their AYM team. Amen? Last announcement before I let you go is next Sabbath, I believe it is. Next Sabbath at 10 o'clock. What time did I say? Next Sabbath at 10 o'clock, the Sabbath School Department will be serving breakfast. Amen. If you have not had that breakfast, you have missed it. Amen. I don't usually tell people what they missed, but you missed it. Amen. So please, please come out at 10 o'clock. And it will be ending, I guess, about 10:15. So please come out if you want to be served. It is a really special breakfast. Let's help support our Sabbath School and the team. Amen. Let's go ahead. At this moment in time, we're going to ask. We're going to have prayer. Where is Betty? There she goes. I'm so sorry. There you go. There you go. Let's all stand.
Let's bow our heads for a minute, please. Dear Lord, thank you for this wonderful, wonderful Sabbath day. Thank you for allowing us all to be here on Facebook Live or in person, and thank you for the wonderful service that we received today. Please allow us to have travel mercies as we all exit the building, and thank you for everything you have done. Keep in mind and prayer.